Physics and Science, and this is What Factors Affect Enzyme Activity. Okay, so today we're going to look at how enzymes function, and we're going to test what environmental factors affect enzyme activity. So, I'm going to take my test tubes, and I'm going to write test tube A on one. I'm going to write test tube B on the next one. And I'm going to write test tube C on the third one. So let's look at some of the supplies that we're going to be using in this lab. We're going to be using vinegar. We're going to be using Benedicts solution. We're going to be using distilled water. We're going to be using starch solution. And we're going to be using a digestive enzyme called amylase. Now, I picked up these at a lab supply company. I thought they were just the greatest little things. They're little pipettes, and each one of these will do a half a mil per squeeze. And they're disposable, so they're really easy ways for you to dispense stuff and to have them disposable and not take up a lot of space in your lab. So I just thought they were really great. So I've got test tubes A, B, and C, and what I'm going to be testing today is what environmental factors affect enzyme activity. I'm going to start with my enzyme, amylase. And I'm going to put 2 milliliters in each test tube. Okay, since this is a half a mil, I'm going to need 4 squirts in each test tube. Okay, remember I have used this now, so it needs to go in the waste container. So I don't need to have it anymore. So I'm going to put it in the waste container and get rid of that. Okay, so we're done with our amylase. I'm going to move it to the side. The next thing we're going to add is vinegar to test tube A. Vinegar, if you remember, is a weak acid. So we're going to see if acid affects enzyme activity. And I'm going to put 2 dropperfuls of vinegar into test tube A. I'm going to set my vinegar to the side because we're through with that. Now, test tube A, we're testing does the weak acid affect the enzyme activity? So I'm going to grab this test tube and I'm going to stir by thumping it. A couple of ways you can do this. I've seen the thumping method. There's a way that you can take it on the tabletop and do it this way. But I always prefer just thumping it. And that mixes it up really well. Okay, since we only put the vinegar in test tube A, we have a difference in volume in the test tubes. So I want to even that out. I want to even that volume out by using distilled water. So I'm going to grab my test tubes. Yeah, see the volume difference? And so I'm going to grab me a new pipette, and I'm going to go with the dropper and add some distilled water to the other tubes until the volume is roughly the same in test tubes B and test tube C. Now this is just regular distilled water. And I want to make sure my volumes are the same. Okay? We don't want volume to be a factor in our lab, so we want to make sure we account for the volume difference. So we've just added plain old distilled water to that. I'm going to put that aside. Okay, so now I'm going to put test tube B. So we're going to, in test tube A, we put vinegar, which is an acid, and amylase. In test tube B, we put amylase and distilled water. So I'm going to take test tube B and put it under high temperature. And so we're going to let this boil in this test tube for about 10 minutes or so. To let that enzyme really break down. Okay, so I've taken test tube B out of the hot water bath, and now I'm going to put starch solution. The starch solution. I'm going to put 5 milliliters in each one. Now I've put starch solution in each one. I'm gonna dump them to mix. Now we need to let that starch solution and amylase sit together for about 10 minutes or so. At this point, the amylase is breaking down the starch into simple sugar. Benedict solution, which is this blue solution here, is a test for simple sugars. If only starch is present, then Benedicts will stay blue. If the starch solution converts into simple sugars, the starch solution will turn orange to reddish, orange to red, depending on the amount of simple sugars present. So we're going to let these sit for a little bit. So it's been about 10 minutes. So I'm going to take my Benedict solution. I'm going to put 2 droppers full in each test tube. And now I'm going to take all 3 test tubes and put them into the hot water bath. Also, don't forget to stir these up again. So I'm going to take all 3 of these and put them in our hot water bath. And I'm going to put all 3 of these test tubes in, A, B, and C. And we're going to let these go until we see a color change. And you should see a color change pretty quick. Okay, C is our control group, so we actually can see that the color change in C is quite dramatic, especially compared to A and to B. Now remember to be careful. This is quite hot. So I'm going to remove these with the special heat gloves. All right, so let's look at our results. This was our control group. Remember, we didn't do anything to this other than add a little bit of distilled water. So this would be a positive test for simple sugars. Notice that the amylase has turned the starch into simple sugars. Therefore, we got an orange color. In test tube B, although it did change from the blue color, we still have an orange. So you could say that probably heat affected the enzyme. What we say in science is it denatured the enzyme. It made the enzyme non-functional. And of course, test tube A was the one we put vinegar in. So we can say that vinegar or acid affects enzyme activity because we didn't even see an orange form at the bottom. So, environmental factors that affect enzyme activity: pH and temperature affect enzyme activity. Thanks for watching.